A very good morning to all of you. Let me welcome you all for the social class. Today we are going to see chapter 9th of your geography, major industries. Last class we have seen about understanding industries, earlier in geography la we have seen about understanding industries. In that chapter we have seen how the industries are classified and how the location of the industry is chosen, that is, and what are the factors that affect the locations, that all we have seen in the last class, last chapter. In this chapter we are going to see major industries all over the world. Okay, three major industries we are going to study in this chapter. One is iron and steel industry, and the other is textile industry, and the third one is IT industry, which is nothing but information technology industries. These three industries we are going to study in this chapter, and also we are going to see which are the major producers of iron and steel, textile and IT, and we are going to compare one specific place of particular place or particular region of iron and steel with India oda or particular region we are going to compare in each industries. Okay, this is what we are going to see in this chapter. First let's go into the iron and steel industry. Let's start with first one, iron and steel industry. See how are major industries distributed across various industries, that is what the first topic. Page number 106, in page number 106 they have given you how are major industries distributed across various industrial regions of the world. Abindrada, so three main industries were very famous all over the world. What is one is iron and steel industry, where steel is a major component used in every, maybe in manufacturing, railways and trucks, automobile industries la steel is the main part, and railway tracks, many industries la major component is iron and steel. Okay, steel is the major component in most of the industries. So the most the major industry is, first is iron and steel industry, and the second one is textile industry. We are going to see where these industries are famous. Okay, see, first is iron and steel industry. It is very famous in these countries. Okay, Germany, India, USA, China, all have to note down all these important points. Okay, Germany, India, USA, China, Japan and Russia, these were the famous iron and steel producing countries of the world. Okay, and coming to the next type of industry, textile industry. We all know textile industry also plays a major role. Okay, textile industry, which countries are famous abdina, look at this: China, India, UK, Italy, Germany, South Korea and Japan. These countries were famous in, these countries plays major role in textile industry. Coming to the IT industry, IT industries, which is nothing but information technology. In that, two main countries are famous, two major countries are very famous. One is USA and the other is India. See, one is USA. USA lo or place vandu very famous, Silicon Valley in California. In California there is a place called, there is a city called Silicon Valley, that is very famous for IT industries. Okay, and in India we call Bangalore as all, we call Bangalore is also as Silicon Valley of India abdin koopdu onliya. So in California there is a place called Silicon Valley, in that there is large number of IT parks are there, adhaadu information technology industries are there in Silicon Valley. So we call Bangalore as Silicon Valley of India abdin solluvom. Okay va, so these two countries were very famous in IT industry. So this is what major industries of the world. Okay, and we are coming to the next one. Did you know that they have given you Frederick Terman is the father of Silicon Valley? Okay, why he is called as father of Silicon Valley abdin koopidrom abdina, he has created Stanford Industrial Park in 1951, and also he has mentored his students, that is he has taught his student to go in this business path, in the IT industries la you just start your industries, you just start your business abdin he has mentored his students. Okay, so he is called Frederick Sturman is the father of Silicon Valley. Okay, he is father of, he is an American professor and researcher. He is called as the father of Silicon Valley. Okay. This is what? So this is what given in your first, how are major industries distributed across the various regions. And coming to the next one, then we will just move on to the how the iron and steel industries are famous. Adhile enala important regions irukku and how the steel is manufactured. That is what we are going to see in this video. Okay. How the iron and steel industries developed across the globe. See, identify the primary raw material. Activity 1, they have given you first is or an aeroplane. Okay. It's like an aeroplane. And the next is truck. And the next is a bridge. For everything we need a steel, Lilia. See, look at this. It is a steel bridge. See. So the major component used in this, in all these types, the primary raw material which is used in this, in these industries are steel. So the common material necessary to build all these is steel. Steel is very important. You may have seen in many places we use the main component as steel. Okay. So iron and steel are the major components we use for steel plates, rods, bolts, everything. Okay. For example, in nama veetlaye you just check it out. For windows, gates, nariya place la we use steel. Kitchen la we will use steel, and for everything we use steel. Okay. So these were the so we call iron and steel industry as feeder industry appdin solluvom, okay, because this is a major component for many industries. Appo feeder appdin enadhu, it is feeding to other industries. So this industry is called feeder industry. Okay, can you all understand? So then coming to the next paragraph. Before 1800, iron and steel were located in areas where raw materials were readily available. அதாவது எந்தெந்த பிளேஸில் இருக்கோ iron ores, அதாவது the raw materials wherever it is there only the industries are located. But after 1800 க்கு அப்புறம் வாட் ஹேப்பன் அப்படின்னா, எங்கே from where the raw materials can be easily accessible, adhaadu for example transportation, it can be transported easily, then there the industries are located. After that, how the places are located appadina near ports, adhaadu evlo distance a irundhalum paravaala, it can be transported through. We started importing, exporting panna aarambichta, okay va. Then it is set up all over the world during 19th century, 1950s lalla the production of iron and steel vandu increase aayirche. As a result, iron ore had to be imported from different place to meet the increasing level, and the level and the demand meet pandradhukaga they started importing it to the countries kula kuda they started importing it. Okay, hence steel plants began to set up on large areas near seaports. Okay, as I have already told you, near seaports vandu they started setting up iron steel. Okay, iron steel plants vandu they started setting up. Okay, importance of iron and steel industry in India la how is it very important abindradha, because India is the second largest producer of steel in the world. Okay, definitely first will be China. சரியா, எப்பவுமே ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வில் மோஸ்ட்லி மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் த டைம் த லார்ஜஸ்ட் ப்ரொடியூசிங்கில் மோஸ்ட்லி வந்து சைனா வில் பி த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டீல் ப்ரொடியூசிங்கில். ஓகே, ஸ்டீல் ப்ரொடியூசிங்கில் இன் ஸ்டீல் ப்ரொடியூசிங் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இஸ் சைனா, செகண்ட் இஸ் இந்தியா, தேர்ட் இஸ் ஜப்பான். See, in your book page number 108 la last line la they have given you India became the third largest producer of steel in the world, in that is 2015-16 ranking. Okay va, in 2019 la India has overtaken Japan overtake panni it has came to the second position. Okay va, so the largest, India was the second largest steel producing country in the world. Okay, first is China, second is India, third is Japan. Okay, so since India is a developing country, அப்படின்றனால most of the அந்த iron and steel plants வந்துட்டு ரொம்ப profit கொடுக்க ஆரம்பிச்சிச்சு. So it was the backbone of economic development in India. இந்தியாவோட economic developmentக்கு it was the backbone of இந்தியா. இந்தியாவோட ஒரு பேக் போனாக இருந்துச்சு, பிகாஸ் இட் ஸ்டார்டட் கிவிங் எக்கனாமிக்கலி ஸ்ட்ராங்கர் ஆக்க ஆரம்பிச்சிச்சு. ஓகேவா, இந்தியாவை. ஸோ மெனி மெனி இண்டஸ்ட்ரி ஸ்டார்டட் டிபெண்டிங் ஆன் அயர்ன் அண்ட் ஸ்டீல். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், லோக்கோமோட்டிவ், ஷிப் பில்டிங், ஹெவி அண்ட் லைட் மெஷினரிஸ், கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் எக்யூப்மெண்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸ், ரயில்வேஸ், பவர் பிளான்ஸ், எவ்ரி திங், பில்டிங் பிரிட்ஜஸ், இன்ஃப்ராஸ்ட்ரக்சர் டெவலப்மெண்ட், ஆல் தீஸ் பிளேசஸில் தே ஸ்டார்டட் யூஸிங் அயர்ன் அண்ட் ஸ்டீல். ஓகே, ஸோ இந்தியா இஸ் இந்தியா ஸ்டார்டட் இம்ப்ரூவிங் இன் எக்கனாமிக்கலி எக்கனாமிக்கலி இட் ஸ்டார்டட் இம்ப்ரூவிங் அண்ட் பேக் போன் ஆஃப் எக்கனாமிக் டெவலப்மெண்ட் இன் இந்தியா இஸ் அயர்ன் அண்ட் ஸ்டீல் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி. ஓகே, திஸ் இஸ் வாட் தே ஹவ் கிவன் யூ இன் த ஹவு த அயர்ன் அண்ட் ஸ்டீல் இண்டஸ்ட்ரிஸ் டெவலப்ட் அக்ராஸ் த குளோப், அதில் வந்து தே ஹவ் கிவன் யூ. அண்ட் கம்மிங் டு த நெக்ஸ்ட் டாபிக், ஹவு இஸ் ஸ்டீல் மேனுஃபேக்சர். ஓகே, எப்படி வந்து ஒரு ஸ்டீலை மேனுஃபேக்சர் பண்ணுவோம்? ஆஸ் யூஷுவல் ஃபார் அ மேனுஃபேக்சரிங் ப்ராசஸ் வி ஹேவ் த்ரீ ஸ்டெப்ஸ். ஒன் இஸ் இன்புட், ப்ராசஸ் அண்ட் அவுட்புட். எப்போவுமே வி ஹவ் சீன் ஆல்ரெடி இன் ஜியாகிரஃபியில் பிஃபோர் கிளாஸ் பிஃபோர் சாப்டர்ஸில் வி ஹவ் சீன். ஓகே, லாஸ்ட் சாப்டர்ஸில் வி ஹவ் சீன் த்ரீ மேஜர் காம்பனன்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் மேனுஃபேக்சரிங். ஒன் இஸ் இன்புட், செகண்ட் இஸ் ப்ராசஸ், தேர்ட் இஸ் அவுட்புட். ஸோ இன்புட்டில் வாட் எவர் வில் பி த இன்புட். ஓகே, so industrial cycle la these were the three components. How the so the raw materials will be raw materials such as iron ore, coal, limestone, along with labor, capital and other infrastructure or some of the important inputs for the industry. Industry ku input varakudiyad ella what are the inputs appadina components. Okay, raw materials such as iron ore, coal, limestone, these were the raw materials. From iron ore we take the important metals, whatever we want we'll take. Okay, we'll extract that using smelting process. Use panni we'll extract the metals, whatever materials we need from the iron ore we'll extract it. Okay, using smelting process. So raw materials such as iron ore, coal, limestone, along with லேபர் கேபிட்டல். லேபர் ஆல்சோ கம்ஸ் இஸ் இன்புட். கேபிட்டல் அப்படின்னா ஒரு இண்டஸ்ட்ரியை ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னா வி நீட் அ மணி இல்லையா, ஸோ தட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அன் இன்புட். அண்ட் அதர் இன்ஃப்ராஸ்ட்ரக்சர், ஒரு சி ஃபார் மேனுஃபேக்சரிங் அ ஸ்டீல் வில் பி த அவுட்புட். ப்ராசஸ்னா வி ஆர் எக்ஸ்ட்ராக்டிங் எவ்ரி திங் இல்லையா, தட் இஸ் கால் ஒரு ஸ்டீலை ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணுவோம் இல்லையா, தட் இஸ் கால் ப்ராசஸ். ஸோ பிஃபோர் தட் எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் அன் இன்புட், including labor, capital, infrastructure and raw materials. These four are the input. And the raw materials like we have coal, limestone, iron ore, all these were raw materials. So we need all these things for manufacturing a steel. So the second process, the process of converting iron ore into steel involves several stages. Nariya stages la da the iron ore is made into a steel. So first stage is smelting. Smelting is a first process, because we have to extract a metal from an iron ore by melting, by the process of melting. That is the melting process. Panni we have melting and heating, these two process should be done to extract a metal from its iron ore, or iron ore la irundittu we have to extract. Okay, we have to heat that. Okay, and the iron ore heat pannu beyond the melting point. Adoda melting point vida adhigama we have to heat it. Adhaadu the iron ore should melt. So till that we have to do, we have to heat. So that process is called smelting process. Okay, sure. Then coming to the next one, the refined iron. So the refined iron is extracted to make steel, which is the output. அந்த ரீஃபைன்ட் அயர்ன் தான் ஸ்மெல்டிங் ப்ராசஸ்க்கு அப்புறம் வரக்கூடிய அந்த அயர்ன் ஷுட் பி எக்ஸ்ட்ராக்டட் டு மேக் ஸ்டீல் விச் இஸ் த அவுட்புட். ஸ்டீல் இஸ் அன் அலாய். ஹவு த ஸ்டீல் இஸ் ஃபார்ம் அப்படின்னா, ஸ்டீல் இஸ் அன் அலாய் ஃபார்ம்டு பை ஆடிங் கார்பன் டு அயர்ன். அயர்ன் அயர்ன்க்கு கூட carbon seitho appadina that is called steel. Okay, we are adding an alloy appadina other main components kuda we are adding something. Okay, extra components vandu add pandratha, that is called alloy. We'll call it as alloy. Alloy is a metallic component made by combining two or more metallic elements sekkrada, because a steel is an alloy formed by adding carbon to iron. Carbon kuda iron vandu add pannu appadina that is called alloy. Okay, so adding two or more metallic elements, two elements we are adding, one is carbon and the other is iron, so we call steel as an alloy. Okay, other metals like nickel, chromium, manganese, copper are added to enhance the properties of steel. So after smelting process we have to add carbon to iron and the iron ore la iron la we have to add carbon, and also some other metals like nickel, chromium, manganese, copper are added to enhance the properties of and the steel oda property. Adhaadu, for example, you have seen the steel illaya, and the valuvalan irukku illaya, for that we have to add some other metals. And also alloying hardens the steel and prevents it from rusting. Thuru pudikama irukkuradhukaga we are adding alloying. Alloying is nothing but adding one or more metallic elements to the component. Okay, this is how the steel is manufactured. Now coming to the next topic, where are the major steel manufacturing regions located? Where are the major steel manufacturing regions located? In USA la we have steel manufacturing major steel manufacturing region in Pittsburgh abindrathu. This is what we are going to compare, Pittsburgh in USA and India la Jharkhand la Jamshedpur. This is what we are going to compare. I have already told you ஒரு ஸ்டேட் ஒரு கண்ட்ரியில் இருக்கக்கூடிய ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் பிளேஸ் அண்ட் ஆர் இந்தியாஸ் ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் பிளேஸ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு கம்பேர் ஹவு தேர் ஸ்டீல் இஸ் ப்ரொடியூஸ் அண்ட் ஹவு ஹியர் ஸ்டீல் இஸ் ப்ரொடியூஸ். தட் இஸ் வாட் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி ஹவு த லொக்கேஷன் இஸ் சூசன். அதோட அதை பற்றின ஒரு ஸ்டடி வில் பி தேர் இன் ஆர் சாப்டர். ஓகே, ஸோ வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி மேஜர் ஸ்டீல் மேனுஃபேக்சரிங் ரீஜன்ஸ் இன் வேர்ல்ட். ஓகே, ஃபர்ஸ்ட் யூஎஸ்ஏல வி ஹாவ் Pittsburgh அப்படின்ற place that is famous for steel manufacturing, and in China Manchuria and Yangtze were famous place in China, and Japan la Osaka we have Kobe, and Tokyo we have Yokohama. Okay, Yokohama, and in Osaka we have Kobe, and in India we have some certain places which have famous cities that is famous for steel manufacturing. Okay, in West Bengal two places, one is Burnpur and Durgapur, and in Jharkhand Bokaro and Jamshedpur. Chhattisgarh la we have Bhilai steel plant. Steel manufacturing plant is very important, and Odisha we have Rourkela. See, these names were very 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 important. In Jamshedpur we have seen illama what is that major steel iron and steel industry, Tata iron and steel industry we have seen illaya. So TISCO, Tata iron and steel industry, is located in Jamshedpur, Jharkhand. Okay, see, in Chhattisgarh Bhilai, Odisha we have Rourkela, Karnataka we have Bhadravati and Vijayanagar, in Andhra Pradesh we have Visakhapatnam because it is located near seaports. Okay ma, the place is chosen near seaports also. Okay ma, and also Bokaro, and these were very famous. And in Tamil Nadu we have Salem. Okay, in Salem we have steel manufacturing plant. Okay, for example till Odisha, all these places contribute to these four places. Okay, all these four places contribute to Chota Nagpur Plateau. Okay, well, we have already seen Chota Nagpur Plateau is famous for steel producing area. Okay, Chota Nagpur Plateau, all these three and these four states, okay, West Bengal, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh and Odisha, all these four states contribute to Chota Nagpur Plateau. Okay, then coming to the next one, see, India's steel production was 1889 point actually in 1947 la it was just 1 million ton mattuna irundhuchu steel producing after 1947 la in 2015 to 16 la our India steel producing vandu 89.32 million tons of steel was produced in India, okay va? So then only then India becomes third largest steel producer in India during the year 2015-16, but we are in 2021, so we have to know the recent rank, okay, the recent data we have to know. So steel producing la India was the second largest. It has overtaken what? Japan. Actually during that time India was third, illiya, it was Japan was the second. During this 2019 ranking la China was the first steel manufacturing largest steel producing country, and India was the second largest, and Japan was the third largest country steel producing country in the world, okay. So you have to change that in page number 108 la last line you have to change. In 2019 la India has become second largest steel producer in the world, okay. We are going to see about two states, okay, two places I have already said you, we are going to see two major region of various states, okay, various cities. One is USA la Pittsburgh, that we are going to see, and the other is Jharkhand la Jamshedpur. We are going to see about Tata Iron and Steel Company, TISCO, okay, TISCO. So okay, see these this is what the major we are going to see about a study of in page number 108, a study of iron and steel industry in Jamshedpur, India and Pittsburgh, USA, okay va? We are going to compare USA la Pittsburgh and the place and Jamshedpur, India. India la Jamshedpur. So these two iron and steel industries we are going to compare. So in India we have TISCO, which is set up in 1907 by Jamshedji Tata. You all know, yeah, Tata Group's oda head, okay, father of Tata Groups, okay. It is set up at Sakchi place in Bihar. At that time it was in Bihar, now it is in Jharkhand, okay, you all have to know, now it is in Jharkhand, and it is located on the rivers of, we all know, liya, it is located on the rivers of Subarnarekha and Karkai. Subarnarekha and Karkai. After that, Sakshi was after the setup of TISCO in Sakshi, it has become as Jamshedpur. Jamshedpur abdina, later it was called as, because who has set up this TISCO? Jamshedji Tata. Avangaloda name la founder of TISCO was Jamshedji Tata. After that, this Sakshi was named as Jamshedpur, because ivangaloda name vachu it was named that. Okay. So how the place was chosen abdina? It was chosen for various reasons. The nearest railway station was just 32 kilometers at Kalimati on the Howrah Nagpur line. It was just 32 kilometers away from the railway station. So because the how the mode of transportation, it can be It can be either transported using railway or airway or else seaport. Seaports valiyada it can be transported. So it was located near it was located just 32 km away from the railway station, Kalimati railway station, and also Jharia coal fields. Okay, Jharia coal fields la irundittu the coal can also be taken, and also iron ore, other minerals like iron ore, dolomite, limestone, manganese were obtained from Odisha and Chhattisgarh. Odisha and Chhattisgarh kitta irundittu we are getting other ores. Okay, this was the advantages. Okay, there are many reasons for choosing this particular place. Okay, and the Karkai and Subarnekar were flowing along the outskirts of the city, which gives adequate supply of water. It gives water supply because we need or steel produce பண்றதுக்கு obviously we need water இல்லையா. So it is located near Karkai and Subarnarekha rivers across. It is situated near that. Moreover, proximity to Kolkata, which offered large market, was also advantageous because it is near Kolkata. Okay, ma, it can be easily transported to Kolkata. It has a large market space for steel. Steel ku or nalla market irukkirathu vandu it is major places Kolkata. And also favorable government policies ensured easy loans. We have seen some set of factors affecting the location. We have seen in that capital, government policies, climate, all these things were chosen, Ilya. All these factors were the all these factors. Water supply, we have Subarnarekha and Karkai rivers, and raw materials we have chosen, and transport market the same. The factors that we have explained with an industry, and the industry could compare pani, we are seeing all these things. Okay, and favorable government policies ensured easy loans and sufficient capital for the development of iron and steel industry here. Due to the development of iron and steel in Jamshedpur, other allied manufacturing such as chemical manufacturing, manufacturing of locomotive parts, agricultural equipments, machineries, tin plates, cables, wires also came up in this region. Adukapra major steel vachu where the steel is the major component, and the industries also started developing in this region appdin sollirukanga. And we are look at the picture. He is the founder of TISCO. Jamshedji Tata is the founder of TISCO. And we are going to see Pittsburgh in USA, and that company also we are going to see, that iron and steel company. Okay, the steel industry is located in Pittsburgh, and it also has the same advantages as TISCO. TISCO madri all these advantages. So it is located, we have seen Subarnarekha and Karkai rivers were famous. Here, what are the two rivers, ma? Here we have Mono Ganghela and Allegheny rivers. These two rivers were very famous. Okay, these two rivers supply water to this steel plant. Okay, this steel plant, it these three rivers. And also we have Ohio rivers, Mono Helena, Hela, and Allegheny. These three rivers supply water to Pittsburgh, USA. Pittsburgh steel plant, USA. And also iron ores vandu, from where iron ores are taken appadina Minnesota. Iron ores from Minnesota. Minnesota, and also it is located about 1500 away, and coal is available locally. So the finished steel is transported to the market using both land and water routes. Both the routes it is transported, and also Great Lakes waterway is the one of the world's best shipping routes. That is the shipping routes ku best waterway edha appadina Great Lakes waterway. This is the main thing. And many allied factories located in Pittsburgh use steel as the raw material to make heavy products like railroads, equipments, heavy machineries and rails. The same like TISCO, all these things were located, all these factors also ensure in Pittsburgh, USA. Okay, well, these two steel plants were very famous steel plants in the world. Okay, I hope you all understand this, and we'll see the remaining. How are the, where the textile industries are manufactured, and which are the major regions, and we'll also compare the same like this. The same we are going to compare two major regions in the in various countries that we are going to compare, and also we are going to see IT industries in the next class. Thank you, students.